The Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. May the Lord bestow His grace and blessing upon all. Amen. I would like to congratulate all of you. Today is the vesper of the Palm Sunday, one of the biggest and favorite feasts in our church. And today, church is trying to prepare all of us for this great event, to prepare us to receive the King of Kings inside our hearts. Tomorrow, our Lord Jesus Christ will enter Jerusalem and give a big joy and gladness to the all people and the multitudes. And my question is today, or Jesus' question for all of us today, would you like to have the same joy as I did to the multitude in Jerusalem, or no? I will leave this question for you. But to answer this question, I would like to talk a little bit about what will happen if we allow our Lord Jesus Christ to enter our hearts. I will talk on 3 points. And based on what happened on the Palm Sunday, there was 3 events. The first one, people spread their clothes in the road. And the second, the others cut down the branches and of the trees and spread on the roads and they carry the branches. And the last thing, the multitudes cry out, say to him, Hosanna to the Son of David. Do you know what is the meaning of this word, Hosanna? What does it mean? Save us. Yeah, we're supposed to say it loudly. Save us, okay? Yeah. So let me talk about the first event. The people who put their clothes in the road. This was an old Eastern tradition. They used to do it when they made a victorious king. When the kings occupied a country or come back from a war after he defeated his enemy, they come back to his kingdom and the people used to meet him putting their clothes on the road. It's a sign of submission. The people at that time tried to show their loyalty and obedience to this king by putting their clothes under his feet. And are we ready to do this today? To tell our Lord Jesus Christ, we are submitting our life to you today. Do we have any sign of obedience and loyalty for him? And if we accept our Lord Jesus Christ to enter inside our hearts, by that acceptance, we give him a permission. Because he will never enter our hearts without the permission from us. But as soon as you give him that permission, you are submit your life to him. You are telling him, please Jesus, do whatever you want in my heart. You are telling him, please God, deal with me according to your goodness. Control my life, clean my heart. I need nothing, but I need you to be my king, to control all my life. Let me follow you. Let me follow your commandment. Because if he controlled our life and our hearts here in this world, he will accept us in the heavenly kingdom. So that's a mandatory step, to be with him in the eternal life. We need to submit our heart and our life to him here on earth. This is the first point. It's a sign of obedience, loyalty, and submission. The second point, the people cut down the branches of the trees and they put in front of him. And there was 2 kinds of branches. Do you know what kind of branches did they use? One of them, the palms. And what is the other branches did they use? Olive, exactly. So they used 2 different kind of branches. Do you know what are the symbols of using those? What is the symbol of the palm? What's it represent? It represents the victory. And the olive represents the peace. I think some people, especially the youth, they felt shy to carry the palms. Correct? Correct? Yes. Say yes. Yes. I have that stage in my life. Yes, say yes loudly. Yes. We felt shy to do that. But let me give you an example. If you are participating in a competition and you won that competition and they give you a trophy, do you feel shy to raise the trophy? Of course, no. You will do it. Because you feel proud that you did something good. And today the church want to give us a sign. This is a sign of victory that our Lord Jesus Christ gave it to us. Victory over sin, victory over the devil. So please don't feel shy to carry it. It's a sign of the victory. Christ gave us that victory over the sin. But when will it be worthy to receive that great gift? We will receive that great gift when we submit our heart to Him, when we let Him enter to our heart. So the other kind of branches, the other kind of tree was the olive branches, which represent the peace. Noah, when he was in the ark, he sent a dove to check what's going on outside, if the land is ready for him to come out or not. And what happened? The dove came back with an olive branch. It represents the peace. God when he gave him message that the flood destroyed all the evil power from the earth. And so you can come out and you can live in peace. Today our Lord Jesus Christ gave our message, I am the King of Peace. If you want to have that peace, you need to let me enter to your heart first to give you that great gift. Actually, during the whole Great Lent, we are asking the Lord Jesus Christ for that heavenly peace. If you are attending regularly in all liturgies, we have a hymn called Tihirini. Did you hear that before? Did you hear that before? That hymn? It's a gospel response. Did you notice that before? This hymn, Tihirini? Oh my God. No one know it? Okay. So, Tihirini means, the peace of God, which is above all minds, shall keep your heart in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the meaning of Tihirini. Let me repeat again. The peace of God, which is above all minds, shall keep your heart in Christ Jesus our Lord. We are struggling in our life. We have a very stressful life. There is a stress at home, stress at work, driving. Even we're under stress when we find a parking around the church. We are stressed. So, the only one who can give us this peace is our Lord Jesus Christ when we allow Him to enter to our heart. So, the last point, when the multitudes cried out, save us, Hosanna, the people asked Him to save them from the Romans. This was the main point. They asked Jesus to save them from the Romans, and they need Him to restore the kingdom of David again. But actually, this was not the main purpose. Jesus came here for a different reason, to save all human race from the devil and from the sin, not saving Jews from the Romans. He came us to save from the bondage of devil. We have a lot of bad stuff we need to get rid of. In the second epistle of St. Paul to Corinthians, chapter 6, verse 2, it says, behold now is the accepted time. Behold now is the day of salvation. Today is the day of salvation. I want you to do this. Every time the deacon said Hosanna or Hosanna, you need to say Hosanna from 1, 2, 3, 4. Save me from myself. Save me from my bad thoughts. Save me from gossip. Save me from telling lies. Save me from envy. Save me from hating people. Save me, save me, save me. We need to cry out, say, with those multitudes to our Lord Jesus Christ to save us from all those bad things. كل سنة وانتم طيبين النهاردة عشان يتحدى الزعف. النهاردة فرصة كويسة قوي وبكرة فرصة كويسة قوي لينا ان احنا نسمح لربنا يسوع على كل المجد زي ما دخل أورشليم يدخل في قلب كل واحد فينا. عادة لما بيجي لنا ضيف البيت ما نقعد ننظف البيت ونروق ونفاكيوم ونجيب جوس ونجيب حاجات ياكلها ما عشان جينا ضيف لازم شكلنا كويس قدامه. انما الوحيد اللي ما بيطلبش كل الطلبات دي هو ربنا يسوع على كل المجد. لانه ببساطه شديده هو مش جاي ياخد منك حاجه. ده هو جاي ياخد كل الحاجات اللي مش كويسه اللي عندك ويديك حاجات بدلها كويسه تعيش بيها. جاي يشيل الحزن اللي جواك ويديك فرح. لو جواك الم بأي نوع يشيل ويديك تعزية. لو جواك هم يشيل ويديك مكانه سلام. بس الفكرة فين؟ ان انت لازم ايه؟ تفتح الباب. لو ما فتحتش الباب هيفضل واقف ايه؟ يخبط. عارفين الصورة بتاعت هذا انا واقف على الباب اقرأ؟ عارفين الصورة دي؟ لو تبصوا على الصورة دي كويس هتلاقوا الصورة دي ما فيهاش اكرة من باب من بره. باب ما فيهوش اكرة. عمركم شفتوا باب ما فيهوش اكرة من بره؟ دي أباب قلوبنا. هي من جوه بس. عشان ربنا يديك حق إن أنت يا تفتح يا ما تفتحش. بس يوم ما تفتح وتقبل ربنا يبقى موجود في حياتك يغير كل حياتك. مشكلتنا إن إحنا ساعات بنفتح الباب. بس بنقبل ربنا وجنبيه حاجات تانية. يعني يبقى رقم 4 أو 5 في أولوياتنا. الوضع ده ما يناسبش ربنا، ما يعرفش يشتغل بيه. لما يلاقي ليك اولويات تانية يقول لك خلاص، ما دام ليك اولويات تانية خلاص. انت تقدر تاخد بالك من نفسك، تاخد بالك من شغلك، تاخد بالك من اولادك فكمل. لكن ربنا لازم يبقى رقم واحد. وهو يقدر يعتني بكل اللي جاي بعد كده. ما قدامناش طريق تاني نرتاح بيه ونريح بعضينا بيه غير ان احنا نفتح قلوبنا لربنا ان يدخل زي ما دخل لأورشليم. المسيح لما دخل ادى فرح وسلام لكل اللي موجودين. كل الشعب اللي حواليه كان بيصرخ يقول له ايه؟ خلصنا. احنا كمان عايزين نعمل كده. انا قلته بالانجلش هقوله بالعربي. اديكوا تدريب صغير. بكره او النهارده كل مره نقول فيها وصلنا لابن داود نقول له يا رب خلصنا. خلصنا من الافكار الوحشه اللي في دماغنا. خلصنا من الكره اللي جوانا. خلصنا من النميمه اللي جوانا. خلصنا من الافكار الوحشه. كل واحد عارف هو يقول خلصني من ايه. كل واحد عارف ايه اللي تعبه ويقوله. فرصه ربنا بيقول انا جاي لكم. عايزين ايه؟ ايه اللي تعبكم؟ المسيح له كل المجد دخل أورشليم ومعاه ناس كتير قوي. وكان الوقت دوت ده كان يوم 10 نيسان. 10 نيسان ده كان كل واحد يهودي عنده خروف بياخده يروح بيه أورشليم وحطه تحت الحفظ 4 أيام علشان في اليوم الخامس ايه؟ يذبحه وياكله كفصح. عشان كده المسيح اختار اليوم ده بالذات ان يدخل في اورشليم علشان يكون تحت الحفظ. الموكب اللي حوالين المسيح ده الاباء شافوه ايه؟ كل البشريه اللي واخده خروف الفصح بتاعها اللي هو ربنا يسوع له كل المجد اللي هيتذبح ايه؟ مكانها علشان يكفر ايه؟ عن خطايا العالم كله. احنا بكرة عايزين ناخد المسيح ندخله ونتحفظ عليه في قلوبنا زي ما كانوا بيتحفظوا على خروف الفصح لحد ما يدينا ايه الخلاص يوم الايه يوم الجمعة. ربنا يدينا ان احنا نتمتع ببركة الايام اللي جاية ويدينا ان احنا نفتح قلوبنا لربنا يسوع ونقول يا رب خلصنا، خلصنا من اللي تعبنا، خلصنا من خطايانا، خلصنا من شهواتنا. لإلهنا كل مجد وكرامة من الآن والأبد آمين.